In Cambridge, Massachusetts, in 1925, I was born. And my mother and father came from Portugal many years ago. I'd sneak in the movie house to see a movie once in a while, you know, and things like that. But there's no money to see a ball game or take streetcars. We had streetcars. I didn't have the nickel to put in a streetcar. I could always hop on the back end of it with a more than one car to another car, you know. It was tough times. So when I got into the service and I had a nice clean clothes to wear, I got soap and a bucket to wash the clothes in and stuff in the service, but that was like heaven. Mm-hmm. And I sent my mother all the money I could make. Believe it or not, I was the only person in that group that got one stripe, PFC, private first class, because I did so good in the field and I did so good in the jumping. And then our second jump was at the same field, but they lost a dummy. A dummy is what they throw out of the plane first. And where it lands, they know where to drop the other 50 people because they don't want you going in some lake or hills or mountains or something like that. They lost it, so the flight director says, we're going to have to turn back. We lost our dummy. And we'll have to postpone this for another day, too. Something. So I thought to myself, I said, Manuel, you don't even remember going through that door. Everything is total blank and everything worked out okay. Maybe it'll be the same way. I said, I'll volunteer to be the dummy. So I went up to the flight jump master and I says, I can be the dummy. You lost your dummy. I can be the dummy. You can't do that. You don't have enough experience. How do you know? I haven't done it in front of you. So they let me be the dummy. And I remember this time when I went to the door, when they said jump, I remember everything and I hit the ground okay. So I did made that jump. By golly, I made another stripe. I was a corporal now. Before I went to the Pacific, though, I had a day's leave. I went to National City and to see if I could find somebody to dance with. So I saw the on 13th Street, National City, I think it was 13th Street. They had a library, they cleaned the library up for us service people to go and have fun. Because they knew we were all going to the Pacific. So I met this young gal there, her name was Charlotte, she was serving coffee. I says, I'd like for you to dance with me. She says, I'm only 16, I'm not allowed to dance with anyone until I'm 18, you know. So I says, well, I can stay here and talk to you. She says, you can talk to me. And we'll stay here while the dance was going on. And she served me a dozen cups of coffee. So when I was in the Pacific, I was thinking about her and her family quite a bit. And when I came home to San Diego, got the mirror, I come back, it was all cleaned up. I found the house that I had walked into where the dance was over. And I says, Charlotte, I'd like for you to come with me as my companion. She said, what do you mean companion? Well, you be with me, I'll take care of you, I'll send you to school, finish school. By that time, she's 17 and a half. And we'll have fun together. Thing that's light and gay. I'll always think of you that way. I'll find you in the morning sun, and when the night is new, I'll be looking at the moon.
but I'll be seeing you.
Died to take away Tommy. Adios.